David Haugh with Dan Pompei at Wednesday Bears practice at Bourbonnais. Big talk coming into practice today was Michael Vick being spotted in Chicago. Bears seemed like they were distracted. The offense a little sloppy in practice, but Jay Cutler had some nice throws and then some other drops that I think they're just tired of being here right now.
Probably. Camp is getting old. You know, it's kind of practice where it looks like they maybe could have used a guy like Michael Vick to spice things up a little bit, but Vick is not coming to Chicago anytime soon. And I think that's probably a good move by the Bears. They've got to find a way to get by with what they have. This offense certainly is good enough. To me, the bigger questions about this team right now are on the other side of the ball.
Just to clarify the Vick situation, he was in Chicago. The CEO of the Humane Society announced it in a statement that they had a joint meeting, part of Michael Vick's post-prison community service. Had people buzzing. TMZ had he was possibly coming to the Bears. The Bears have ruled that possibility out. They made a statement themselves. Back to football, the defense is, you know, a big concern. You know, you're practicing today without Charles Tillman, without Daniel Manning, without Zach Bowman. Gives another chance to some younger guys, but guys like Al Afalava and Kevin Payne at the safeties and younger corners like Corey Graham and Tremaine McBride really have to take advantage.
They do, and I think it would really help if Nathan Basher would step up. You wrote a nice story about him in today's Tribune, and he got beat on a long pass to Devin Hester in today's practice, so I think there's a guy who really is kind of the key to this defense right now. He can get back to playing like he did 2-3 years ago. They're going to be okay. If he can't, they could be in trouble.
He needs to turn it on. But that play you talked about, people ask, how does a quarterback make a receiver better? One play in particular, on a blitz, Jay Cutler put the ball at the one spot it could be placed, about 40 yards downfield, and Devin Hester came down with the ball, and he beat Nathan Basher.
Well, that's what Jay Cutler does for you, no question. And I think it speaks also to the chemistry that's developing between Cutler and some of his receivers like Hester. You know, if we see some of that in game conditions when the bullets are flying, I think that will really speak well for this offense.
We'll come back tomorrow with more practice. Go listen to Jay Cutler now. Thanks for joining us on ChicagoTribune.com.